The Physics of Basketball by Andy Gu and David Jo. To the beach, y'all. Let's go. All around the world. Y'all know. This is so, so dead. To the beach, y'all. Hey, are you tired of sucking at basketball? Have you ever thought about to use physics in basketball? Well, physics can really help you improve your game.
When the ball is in the player's hand, it has potential energy gravitational. When he starts to let go of the ball's potential energy gravitational turns into kinetic energy until it hits the ground, where it gains potential energy elastic because of the elastic collision it makes with the ground. Kinetic energy is equal to 1/2 mass times velocity squared. So the faster you dribble the ball, the more energy the ball will have, and the harder it will be for your defender to steal the ball.
This is a crossover. In order to get around your defender, you must be able to effectively use a crossover. Your momentum carries you one direction, but in order to cross over, you plant your lead foot into the ground. The force friction between your foot and the ground allows for your momentum to stop for a brief moment and gives you time to change direction. The equation for friction is force friction equals mu Fn. By changing the grip on your shoe, it changes mu, which changes the force of friction.
Now that you know how to get around your defender, you now need to know how to score. The easiest way to score is with the jump shot. By using the angle launch formula, which is delta x is equal to velocity initial squared times cosine of 2 theta divided by acceleration in the y direction, we can find the ideal angle in which to launch a jump shot. To achieve maximum distance, you must release the ball at a 45 degree angle. However, in basketball, the ideal angle to shoot the ball is at 48 degrees.
Another way to ensure your shot goes in is to use the backboard. You can use the backboard on both jump shots and layups. By using the backboard, you are creating an elastic collision between the ball and the backboard. Creating this collision creates angles at which the ball will bounce off and into the hoop. The angle at which you shoot the ball is also the angle at which the ball will bounce off the backboard. Therefore, it is important not to overshoot the ball or undershoot the ball, because it will lead the ball bouncing off the backboard too hard or too soft.
Now you understand the physics of basketball. Now, Confucius said, go to destroy your defender.